This is Simbula. Namaste. Good morning to all respected online viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our. Welcome to this online Ayurveda and Yoga Workshop, Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCR's Nehru Wangchuk Culture Center. Yoga teacher, I'm KVSSN Murthy here. My sincere prayers to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties and the whole Bhutan also. So coming to recitation, so here in this recitation, we are like it is saying that important three qualities. Durlabham tayame vaitat daivanugraha hetukam manushyatvam mumukshutvam mahapurusha samsrayaha. Three important qualities must be required for every human being to get uplifted towards the spiritual upliftment call. One is human birth. Second one is a strong desire to reach towards the spiritual enlightenment, as well as on top of that, so association with the great gurus. So these three are durlabha, means very difficult, but once you, if you will have this kind of three important segments, then don't leave that opportunity. And right, coming to the Ayurveda preparations, so in regarding building the immunity, this week we are seeing very simple and effective home Ayurveda remedies. So in your everyday tea or like in your regular foods, so please add ginger and please add pudina also. Very simple preparation, pudina and ginger. Somewhat it will relax the abdominal disorders. If you don't have any special ulcers or any strong disorders in the abdomen, you can take, like if you have no disorders, you can take ginger. Especially when you have ulcers or any kind of gastritis, but please be aware of using this like a ginger. Please remember, this is very simple and effective remedy to keep your immunity as well as to keep your blood circulation system strong, as well as it will somewhat give the good result in the abdominal health also. So coming to next very simple and effective home remedy, adrak. This is what we call lasun, and especially garlic. So this is local garlic. So take out this local garlic every day in the early morning. Take one or two pieces and properly grind and mix it in the water. You can drink this lasun water or what we call garlic water also early in the morning, after adding a pinch of turmeric in the water. This is also like a anti-cancer food. This is also good in the management of abdominal diseases and disorders also. Also, these two preparations with the ginger and pudina, as well as lasun, garlic, it is also very good to keeping your phlegm-related disorders calm. Especially in these COVID times, we should maintain some kind of food preparations that is really effective on the internal phlegm, internal biles and internal wind also. Now coming to the next preparation called ajuvine seeds. So this is also available in the market. This ajuvine seeds, okay. Now this is what we call, bishop seed. So here, just every day in the morning, every day in the afternoon, and as well as every day in the evening foods, you can take 5 to 6 grams of seeds, properly grind it, and after that take out that powder, and after that roast it on an open pan. So here, after that, you can add a pinch of salt and this powder in mixing with the food in the first portion. This is also good in secretion of saliva, and the remaining glands also will active because of the simple food, as well as this is also good in the digestive glands. It will directly affect on the digestive system. And coming to today's our next last preparation called sont or ginger powder. If you have dry ginger, you can take out that powder, or you can directly use that sont also after mixing it in the food. So here what my request is, so here also you can take nearly, see, this is the portion, 8 to 10 grams of dry ginger powder. So here also please add in the early in the morning while using the salt also, salt and ghee and this is sont, dry ginger powder. It will also act like a medicine, so it will also directly affect on your digestive system, as well as these two preparations, ajuvine seeds and dry ginger powder, also good in management of constipation also. Then, like in a day, morning, evening, or morning, afternoon, evening, or 4 to 5 times, when you have cold related or somewhat tonsil related issues, take out rock salt or common salt. So take 10 to 20 grams and mix it in the water, glass of water, but especially water must be not warm as well as not cold. It must be like bearable hot. It's a drink bearable hot water. It's not really drinking. It's a cleaning of the throat, like gargling. So in a day, 4 to 5 times also, you can clean your throat after adding salt into the bearable hot water, not warm water. So these are very simple and easiest home Ayurveda remedies. So one can easily fit by using these simple preparations. And coming to next, our yoga practices. And today also we have our same regular routine sun salutations with bijakshara and mantra chanting. If you have your traditional beliefs, you can follow this mantra chanting, or else you can just follow the practical yoga. And coming to mantra chanting and bijakshara. Om hiranmayena patrena satyasyapi hitam mukham tatvam pushan apavrunu satya dharmaya drushtaye. ॐ ह्रां ह्रीं ह्रूं ह्रैं ह्रौं रः मित्ररविसूर्यभानुकगपूस्नहिरण्यगर्भमरीच आदित्य सवित्र अर्कभास्कराय नमः. Stretch your both arms forward and lift your both arms up. Keep them straight. From there once, pull yourself up. From there slightly put a back bend, Hasta Uttanasana to Ardha Chandrasana or Ardha Chakrasana. And from there, keep your position straight. From there, very slowly, bend the body forward, Pada Hastasana or standing forward bending. Then after that, keep your right leg as a back leg, Aswa Sanchalanasana, horse riding posture. And after that, back leg straight on the toes, and keep your knee also straight, and join your forward leg to back, Dandasana, few seconds stay here. And bend your knees and keep your chest down, lift your butts up, called Ashta Anga Namaskarasana. And lift the body like a lifted head cobra, called Bhujangasana or cobra posture. Lift your chin, and here do not hang your body in between, completely push yourself up and pull the shoulders down and lift your chin up. And slowly back leg straight on the toes and lift your butts up and push your body inside, called Parvatasana. And right leg must be your forward leg, Aswa Sanchalanasana, horse riding posture. And back leg straight on the toes and back leg knee up, and join your back leg to the forward leg, called Pada Hastasana. And lift your hands and body at a time up without crunching your spine, called Hasta Uttanasana. Here once pull up, then slightly put your back bending towards Ardha Chakrasana or Ardha Chandrasana. Then keep your position straight. After that, Pranamasana above to the head, called Kailasha Mudra. From there to chest, maintain that same Pranamasana, called Anahata Pranamasana. And lift your both arms with inhalation, and with very slowly exhalation, breathe out and keep your hands down at your thighs. Then after that, slightly wide your legs, lock your hands, long and deep, slow inhalations and exhalations. And coming to the actually practices, today we are seeing two standing exercises and remaining postures which can be performed on the supine and prone. So long, deep, slow inhalations and exhalations. So here, wide your legs, in between your legs, create at least 1.5 foot distance. And coming to wide your both hands and lift your both arms up, interlock your fingers once, completely pull yourself up. Then towards your right side, turn the body without turning your feet and knees, only turn the body completely, give a turn and stay now. Tiryak Tadasana, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and very slowly come back with inhalation. And here take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. Once rest your hands, and again take a long deep slow inhalation and exhalation. Then after that again lift your both the arms up. Once pull yourself up towards your left side, give a maximum turn and stay for a while here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then very slowly turn the body and slowly relax your hands and rest on the head. From there slowly move your hands out of the body and slowly keep them together down towards the thighs, and here legs together, and here lock your hands back. Once set your body in relaxation posture and long deep slow inhalation and exhalation. And right, coming to next exercise, balancing posture called T posture or Ekta Pada Asana. So here keep your right leg back as a back leg, then open your both hands forward, then after that back leg straight and lift it up. Then here few seconds maintain that T structured posture and few seconds stay balancing on your single leg. So initially people may get some of imbalancing or cramps around your hips, but immediately relax when you have any inconvenience, and then very slowly keep your hands down and leg also down. Few seconds rest and long and deep slow inhalation and exhalation. All right, opposite side same thing. Keep your right leg forward as a forward leg and left leg back as a back leg, and coming to P position. So here also we are doing same Ekta Pada Asana, long and deep slow inhalation and exhalation. So here open your two hands forward and back leg is your left leg. So lift your back leg up and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then very slowly keep your hands down, rest your leg. Again few seconds rest your spine. Long and deep slow inhalation and exhalation. And so try to sit properly on the knees, called Vajrasana. And here bend your knees and keep your spine down on the thighs. Again long and deep slow inhalation and exhalation. And coming to next exercise called what we call a bridge posture, very simple and effective exercise. So first be comfortable in Shavasana or straight posture. Then after a while keep your both the legs together and hands together, keep your hands at your thighs. Then after that fold your two legs and wide your knees and wide your legs to catch your ankles with your both hands. And here bridge posture is very simple and very easy. Like this is also good posture in maintaining good thyroid imbalancing, as well as it will relieve from the lower backs and above back pain also. So here try to lift your butts up, then very slowly turn your both the shoulders inside and give maximum raise against the gravitational force and stay for a while. Throughout the practice you can hold your ankles or you can put your hands on the floor also. Be very convenient while doing the posture. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then very slowly keep your trunk down and slowly stretch your both the legs forward. And very slowly wide your both the hands and rest for a while in Shavasana. And long and deep slow inhalation and exhalation. So today we are seeing last exercise of this day called Pavana Muktasana with the single leg. Again keep your both the legs and both the hands together, called Samasthiti. Then after that keep your right leg bent and bring them on the abdomen. Then after that you can lock under your calf basil or you can lock on the knee, but press your abdomen here and stay for a while. Then at your convenient region lift your chin up towards your knee or
keep your forehead also towards the knee if possible, but throughout the practice, keep press the abdomen and stay for a while without holding the breath. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then very slowly rest your head, then slowly rest your hands, keep your leg down, and slowly rest your leg also. Here again, long and deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. And soon after that, alternate leg, fold properly. After that, bring them on the abdomen, so called P position. After that, catch above to the knee or below to the calf muscle, but have your proper grip on the leg and completely press the abdomen. Here, lift your chin up and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then very slowly rest your head, relax your throat, relax your chest, slowly relax your hands and rest your leg and stretch your leg, wide your arms and legs. Again, long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. Then after finishing your yoga practices, from your right side or left side, properly make your arms straight and turn towards that arm side, and keep your remaining arm also in front of the chest, and fold your both knees, and once push the body up, then slowly get up and sit up. And coming to pranayama abhyas, so try to sit in any comfortable posture on any comfortable surface. So here, keep your position straight. So here, as we know that in management of immunity, every yoga posture and every yoga exercises has its own benefits, but the way how we are doing, so always try to take good advice from the yoga teacher and from your TM, traditional medical practitioner. Right, coming to the actually practices, yesterday's practices like Kapalabhati, Bhastrika and Anulom Vilom Pranayama. So when you have blood circulation issues or high blood pressure or even low blood pressure or even any cervical spondylitis or throwing sensation or any vertigo issues or any balancing issues, while doing this Kapalabhati, go very slow. Okay, now coming to actually Bijakshara and Mantra Sadhan for the Pranayam, whole Pranayam. Om Kesavaya Swaha, Om Madhavaya Swaha, Om Narayanaya Swaha, Om Adhya Samadhi Tat Palasidhyadham Asana Purvakan Pranayamadhin Karishye. Om Sand Sand Sandhi. And Kapalabhati Sadhan, it is also called as Kapa Dosha Visoshini. So internal phlegm, internal mucus will comes under total balancing while doing this Kapalabhati Sadhan. And long deep inhalation exhalation. And this time we are not doing any variation, so only plain Kapalabhati, plain stroke. So first 10 strokes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, again long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation. Second 10 strokes, again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation without giving a long time gap. Restart the next 10 strokes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then again long deep inhalation and exhalation. So quite opposite side of this Kapalabhati Kriya, we have Bhastrika Pranayam, also we can call as Vata Pitta Slashma Haram Sariragni Vivardhanam. So here internal wind, internal bile, and as well as internal mucus will comes under total control because of this simple pranayam, Bhastrika Pranayam, also called as Sariragni Vivardhanam, and the immunity will be boosting because of this pranayam. But the way how we are doing, but today we are not doing fast. So here also 10 plus 10 plus 10, so slow strokes, keep your position straight and starting 1, then slowly come back 2, then slowly come back 3, then slowly come back 4, come back 5, and come back 6, come back 7, come back 8, 9, 10, then slowly take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. Then second 10, here keep your position straight, starting 1, come back 2, come back 3, come back 4, come back 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then long deep inhalation, exhalation. Last 10 strokes, again keep your position straight, starting 1, then slowly come back 2, come back 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. So coming to last exercises in the pranayam segment called just Anulom Vilom Pranayam or alternative breathing. So this is also good in management of lungs fitness, especially in this COVID times. One should be always aware of the fitness. In this fitness segment, again, lungs fitness. So do at least morning 10 to 20 minutes time, evening 10 to 20 minutes time pranayam, if your time will permits you. It's always advised to do special exercises for the lungs through pranayam. Keep your position straight. And here open your right hand, last two fingers and right hand thumb to close and open the nostril. This mudra called pranayama mudra. So here close your left nostril with the last two fingers of the right hand. Inhalation with the right nostril. Then exhalation with the left nostril. Again inhalation with the left nostril. Opposite side nostril, breathe out. Right nostril, breathe in. Left nostril, breathe out. Left nostril, breathe in. Alternative nostril, right nostril, breathe out. Last inhalation, right nostril, breathe in. And last exhalation with the left nostril. Then slowly keep your hand down. So after practicing pranayam, take at least 10 minutes time to do mantra chanting or ekagrata abhyas, trataka abhyas, or in the sense of meditation also you can do some practices. As well as after finishing your yoga practices, take at least 10 minutes time for relaxing the body called Nidra Yoga or Yoga Nidra after finishing your total workout. So give at least 15 minutes time to take bath, as well as further 5 minutes time to take breakfast, as well as in the afternoon before your lunch. So take out time for power nap in the sense of Nidra Yoga or Yoga Nidra. In the evening time, after finishing your office works and house works and garden works and games and sports and everything, at least half an hour time to do this self yoga exercises, or you can copy the same practices which already saved in this Embassy of India Thimphu Facebook link. As well as in the evening practices, at least try to do one backbending exercises as well as one inverted posture also. In a regular days, try to always aware of the your cough and cold symptoms. When you have cough and cold or fevers or any ailments, do not do your self medication. Don't opt your self medicines. Always choose good physician to take advice. According to the advice only, please use medicines. On your own, don't take painkillers as well as don't take any other drugs. It may be effective in other ways. It may be effective in side effects also. Okay, now tomorrow, while we are meeting here, we will be meet with the different Ayurveda practices and different yoga exercises also. Thanking you all to giving me this light opportunity. So stay away from the bad habits as well as to yoga also. Thanking you all.